Hello everybody, welcome to the Java example section. In this section, I'm going to set up a program to evaluate the matrix multiplication. So I would like to multiply two-dimensional arrays, which resembles the matrix multiplication operation. Before doing the multiplication, I need to check for the dimension match. If the two dimensions don't match, I can't go to the multiplication process. And the idea of the multiplication is by means of a three-level nested for loops to evaluate the elements in the answer of the matrix multiplication. The key idea is like this. We need an index to traverse the row elements of the first matrix together with the column elements of the second matrix in order to complete the multiplication process of the elements inside the two matrices. Now we go to the implementation. I want to multiply two matrices, so I set up the two matrices beforehand. Okay, this is the first matrix, which is simply a two-dimensional array in Java. And the first row of that matrix is having three elements, 1, 2, and 3. And the second row of this matrix is having three numbers, 4, 5, and 6. So M1 is a 2x3 matrix. So now I create another matrix called M2. Okay, M2 is a 3x2 matrix. That means it has three rows and two columns. According to the rules of matrix multiplication, the number of columns in the first matrix has to be the same as the number of rows in the second matrix. So we need to check whether these two values are the same. If they are not the same, I can't do the multiplication of matrices. So if the number of columns in the first matrix is not equal to the number of rows in the second matrix, I cannot define the multiplication in this case. Okay, here M10 means that I pick up the first row of the matrix, and from that row I count the number of elements in that row. So it means that I simply return the number of columns in matrix M1. Here M2.length means that I'm going to pick up the number of rows in the matrix M2, so I have three rows. Okay. If the dimensions of the two matrices can match, I can really do the calculation. I put the calculation in the next part. Here I will produce a static method in the driver class called multiply, and the two matrices will be passed as the actual parameters of the multiply method. So we can try to implement the multiply method now. After that, we will go back to the main method in order to print out the result coming from the matrix multiplication. Now, MAT1 and MAT2 are the two formal parameters of the multiply method. Since I'm going to return the answer from the multiply method in the form of matrix, the return type will be a two-dimensional array of integer primitives. Okay, I set up a local variable called answer, which is simply pointing to a 2D array reference. Okay, here the dimension of the answer matrix would be like this. The number of rows will be equal to the number of rows in the first matrix, and the number of columns will be simply equal to the number of elements horizontally in the second matrix called M2. Okay. When we set up this answer variable, all the elements in the 2D array object are all initialized to be zeros. So this is the property of object instantiation in Java. Now we want to create nested for loops with three levels. I need to loop over the all the rows in the first matrix. I also need to loop over the column elements in the second matrix called MAT2. Okay. Here MAT2 0 means that I'm picking the first row in the MAT2 matrix, and I would like to find out the number of elements in that row. So I simply get the number of columns in the second matrix. Here the index called I is going to traverse the elements in the rows of the first matrix together with the column elements of the second matrix. Okay, for each of the elements in the answer matrix, the elements are evaluated according to this rule. I traverse by using the index called I, and during the traversal, I get the product of two numbers from the two matrices, and then I add up all the products coming from these pairs of elements, and the answer for that particular element with index row and column will be stored in the answer matrix. So after this nested for loops, I am able to create the answer matrix obtained by the matrix multiplication. And after that, I need to return the reference variable called answer to the driver program. Okay, that completes the multiply method. So now we can go back to the main method to see what I can do with the multiply method. Now, after I run the multiply method, I will get the product of the two matrices, and that object is having its reference stored in the variable called result. And from that reference variable, I can print out all the elements in the answer. Now I loop over all the rows in the answer or the result matrix. I also need to loop over the columns in the result matrix. So here a result 0.length means that I'm going to return the number of column elements. Okay. In this way, I can print out one of the rows in the result matrix. And after printing out one row, I need to set a new line before we can print out the other row. I set the new line by using the print line method outside the inner for loop. Okay. So let me save it and run it in order to find out the matrix product of M1 and M2. Okay, a 2x3 matrix multiplied by a 3x2 matrix would return a 2x2 matrix whose elements are these values. Okay. How about changing the positions of M1 and M2. That means I'm going to multiply M2 with M1. So a 3x2 matrix multiplied by a 2x3 matrix would return a 3x3 matrix. Yes, the answer is given here. A 3x3 matrix. Okay. How about the issue of dimension mismatch? I can try here. How about removing one of the rows in M2? So now it is a 2x2 matrix. And then how about doing the multiplication of M1 with M2? Save it. Run it. Yes, the multiplication is not allowed because I cannot do the multiplication between a 2x3 matrix with a 2x2 matrix. The two numbers here and there are not the same. So I can't perform the multiplication according to the rule of matrix multiplication. So this completes the process of a matrix multiplication by using 2D arrays. My code is straightforward and intuitive, but it may not be the best or the most efficient solution to the problem. If you can suggest any idea to improve my code, feel free to do so on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.